Hey now, everybody, it's Jason Acorn here with the Boneyard. This episode we're calling Filling the Freezer, and it's for a good reason. Calvin Buckler is the first kill, and he takes his first bull moose with a bow. Then we're off to my nephew, Andy Acorn, who's guided by his dad, Jeff Acorn, with Acorn Outfitting Adventures. And Andy takes his first bull moose, which is really exciting, especially for me. And then we're after that hunt, we're off to Thad, that's capital T-H-A-D, Buckler.
Let's go get him.
And he dumps a moose, which is just an awesome sight. So stay tuned. We're going to show you what hunting with family and friends is all about. So people, not every animal is taken solely on the amount of bone on their head. When it comes to moose, younger is actually better. So that's why it's fitting for us to name this episode Filling the Freezer, because that's exactly what we did. We went out, and in some zones in Alberta, it could be 4 or 5 years before you get a tag. So when you get a tag and you see a bull moose, you drop it. Because the younger the moose, the better tasting the meat. So this first hunt is Calvin and Chris. Calvin takes his very first bull moose with a bow. I think it was 22 yards or something crazy like that. Chris and Cal have been hunting together for 20 years, pretty much like I have with Chris. So it's pretty exciting for all of us. I was in the area, so I was able to zip down there and be there when they drug it out of the bush. Not before, thankfully, but right after. So you're gonna watch that hunt here coming right up. So the funny thing about this day when Calvin took his moose was that Chris was the actual hunter and Calvin was the cameraman. So the boys keep cow calling. I might have to remind you that they are hunting elk, not moose, when Chris finally sees something in the trees. Well, it's a cow and a bull moose. You'd think that was great, but really it isn't, because Calvin's draw is for 3:48, and that is not the zone that the guys are hunting in. So for those of you who have never hunted Alberta before, the Fish and Game Association has devised specific zones for specific parts of Alberta. They're called wildlife management units. Now, you darn well better know where you're hunting, because if you're outside one of the zones that your specific tag is zoned for, and you shoot something that's not legal, ignorance is a real poor excuse when those lights are flashing. Chris plays with this bull for a few more minutes, and then they head back to the truck and decide to go back and hunt around Calvin's place. So the boys are heading back now, hanging their heads low, boo-hooing a little bit because their dreams of that big bull elk are gone. But I'll tell you, calling in that bull moose was super cool. So I'm still up on the roof. The boys get back to the house. I decide to come down and then shoot some sticks with the guys before they headed back out again. Now that's one of the great things about archery hunting is the weather. It's really a springtime sport and I love it.
Boneyard, I'll be right back.
This segment is brought to you by
Cam Clark Ford, located on the west side of Gasoline Alley Red Deer, Alberta.
Chris and Calvin, they're hunting on some crown land just east of Calvin and Anna's place. And what do you think they see? Running through the trees yet again. Yeah, you betcha. Moose, cows, and a bull. Plus the wind is perfect. So standing in the trees, Chris starts calling. No reaction. Oh, wait a minute. The moose keeps coming. Can you see the look of love in his eyes? If only Chris was a cow. I've heard people say that moose are stupid. You know what? That's the farthest thing from the truth. That moose is 800 pounds and it could crush you in an instant. The moose actually comes in to 12 yards, but unfortunately it gets their wind and runs off through the trees. Hindsight is 20/20. They're in the right zone, but the wrong guy's holding the bow. Do you think they'll ever get it together? Yeah, I have faith in my boys, and they do. So the score now is Bull Moose 2, Chris and Calvin 0.0. The boys are pumped. They had a great day. They are feeling a little dejected about the missed opportunities, but they know they have another shot in the morning, so they pack it in and head home.
Here we're sitting on this, going to the next chunk of bush here, looking for some elk. We were here last year, we had luck on seeing them, but no luck on killing them. So hopefully this year is a little different. We'll head in here and see what we can do.
So Chris must be behaving because Calvin takes him to one of his honey holes. Tracks, rubs, all over the place. So the boys are moving into the trees, periodically calling as they go, keeping the wind in their favor. And yet again, something's moving in the trees.
Oh.
I shot low. Yeah, right. Like, who has a 10-yard pick? Like, Chris, you got to imagine this. We're in the bush. Like, I'm following Chris with the camera the whole way. We've walked probably a mile at least already. This thing's moving in front of us. We're calling elk. We're calling. It's not coming. Finally, we walk up, and here it is. It's a bull moose. Then Chris just calls, first bull moose, you know, first moose call. It just stops, turns, looks at us. So he hands me the bow. I'm trying to put on his release, and this thing is standing behind that spruce tree at like 30 yards. I get everything on. It walks out. Finally, it walks out, you know, after a good minute or two of it standing there looking at us through the trees. We stop it. I had to sidestep, you know, or take two steps to the side because there's a spruce bough in the way. Then I just put the first pin on it. Squeeze the trigger. I smoked him too, like, you know, right. I cut the top of his heart off. He ran 50 yards, stopped, fell over. You know, it was perfect. All is good. But a 10 yard pin, Chris? Come on, buddy. That's crazy. Anyway, the rest is history. And we filled the freezer with that one. It was good eating too, let me tell you.
Killing Sticks. Premium carbon fiber arrows.
Howdy folks, I just harvested my first bull moose with Chris's Matthews adrenaline. we were actually hunting elk, We were actually hunting elk and we heard something in front of us and we thought it was an elk because we were cow calling like crazy and it wouldn't come to us, so we moved ahead. Seen it was a bull moose, Chris handed me the bow, it started to trot away, he called and boom, it just came back in like it was on a string, perfect, walked right out like 22 yards. And I crushed it. And here is the results. Nice young bull, he's gonna be good eating. Done? Oh. And here's my guide.
Right on, welcome to the Boneyard.
Hi, I'm Rachel Attila from Jim Shockey's The Professionals. You're watching the Boneyard on Wild TV, and I'm back to the show.
So now we're on to our second hunt of the episode. It's my nephew Andy Acorn, and it's pretty special for all of us because he's guided by his dad, and this is his very first moose. So the wind is perfect, and the guys have snuck in to about 100, 135 yards. Everybody's calm, they're watching a cow, the young bull steps up. So now they're hoping that maybe there's a bigger bull laying down. In those hills, I'm telling you, there's some monster bulls, and they have that red bone on them that is just unbelievably beautiful.
An egg, this first moose, got a cow and a bull. We're gonna wait for a minute and see if we can't get a bigger one. Should we take him?
So Andy and Jeff, they continue to watch the cow and the bull moose. Now you gotta remember, Andy is 17 years old and this is his first bull moose. The temptation is killing him. So he finally decides, Dad, I'm taking this moose. He loads one in and takes a shot.
Load again. There we go. Well, me high five, man. Andy's first moose. That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Andy's first moose. That's awesome, man. That's awesome.
Way to go, Andy. I'm so proud of you. Now we're on to our third and final hunt of the episode. This is the man, the myth, the legend, Thad Buckler. Now this hunt is not for the faint of heart, and in the words of Thad himself, this moose is boom dead.
Okay, I'm here with Thad Buckler. We're about to kill a bull moose, we're hoping. Here's a tiny deer he shot a few years ago. 140er. Okay, from my deck. There's a cow and a calf. Where'd they go? See, there she is. We're gonna go down there and have a look. It's the old Heartland bow hunter shot with the sun coming up.
Kelvin used to tell me stories about him and his brother shooting the heads off the chickens with 22s when they were young. So I know this shot made by Thad was a relatively easy one.
Because he's got his ass to me. Okay. Otherwise I got to take him in the back, in the neck. So whenever you're ready. This way. 185 meters? Say when. Okay, I'm gonna take him in the neck, Kel.
I would say he's down.
Wow, what a shot. I think the consensus says one more time, slow-mo.
Let's go get him.
So that was an instantaneous kill. It was what every hunter wants. Just imagine a pack of wolves chasing you down.
Harvested one. Nice young bull. Got that?
There you have it, folks. Our very first episode, Filling the Freezer. You would not believe the effort it takes to put a show together that is actually only 23 and a half minutes long. If you liked what you saw, please check us out at Facebook or on Twitter, or check out our website, Adding Bones to the Boneyard. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. We really appreciate it here at the Boneyard.